dear friends. Welcome to Soulstar Alchemy. Gemma here, and I'm broadcasting because there are a couple of major events happening right now, for a few days actually. The first has to do with five of our planets, plus the moon. They will be in their own astrological home signs of rulership. This means that the planets can effortlessly express their powerful characteristics. The energies at play help to accomplish goals and manifest what you're setting out to do more easily and more powerfully. The days from July 2nd through the 12th are exceptional days to set your sights on your goals and step forward with your plans. I'll give more insight so you'll have a better understanding of the energies we're working with. First in line, we have the planet Mercury in its comfortable home of Gemini, which rules the throat chakra or energy center. It will be easier to express yourself organically and authentically. It also stands for willpower and personal freedom. Gemini is an air sign, so when air gets to flow freely, opportunities will become more abundant. Mercury also rules travel, so it's an enjoyable time for it, for work or for play. It also rules the throat chakra as well, so it's a suitable time to send those emails or correspondences and to talk to people. It's time to push through with plans and get things done because conversations will be beneficial, easy, and most of all, productive. This is the time to pitch your pitch to important key people. Thinking will be so much clearer, so set your intentions for this meditation and speak the world you want to bring to life into your existence. The next planet is Venus in Taurus. Taurus rules the heart chakra, and despite all the tragedy and stress going on around the world, this is a suitable time to take notice of all the beautiful things in your life, to expand the energies of gratitude throughout your being and throughout the collective, which really needs it badly. This is a time to integrate the lower and the higher chakras within our body. Doing this will open your heart center. I have a meditation on my Soulstar Alchemy YouTube channel called Heart Coherence Activation. This meditation is a powerful way to connect with and integrate your heart's intuition, so give it a try. Next, we have Mars in Aries. Aries rules the solar plexus chakra. Balancing this chakra will enhance leadership and professional skills. Inner strength and intuition will work hand in hand. One word of caution though, since Mars is in Aries, its astrological sign of rulership, its energies are much stronger, as with all the other planets in its astrological homes. But in the case of Mars in Aries, this is a combination of things going fast and sometimes without thought. So please be very careful when moving about in a hastily way. Just don't do it. Also, have patience, because Aries, especially with Mars, can equal explosive behaviors. Speak mindfully and kindly, and be careful while driving or riding a motorcycle. I just can't express that enough. The upside of this is Mars fires you up to get the ball rolling. So get started on that new project or finish an old one that's been lingering around the back of your mind. The energy will help propel you into completion. So go for it. Now, with all this great energy behind us, we come to Jupiter in Pisces. Jupiter is about expansion. It's the planet of luck, fortune, success, and generosity. Pisces is a spiritual sign ruling the crown and heart chakras. Therefore, finding truth is important, and this event will teach us about compassion and humility. This is also a good time to work on your relationships, whether to work on them to keep it strong or to let them go. Next is Saturn in Aquarius. Saturn is all about responsibility, hard work, and determination. It keeps everyone in check and ensures efficient routes to the desired outcome. Aquarius rules the throat chakra and is a very highly creative sign that can win hearts or contracts because of dedication and innovation. It's also a humanitarian sign that wants to make a difference in the world. And last but not least, we have the beautiful moon in its home sign of Cancer. The moon is all about intuition, feminine aspects and emotions. The qualities of the nurturing sign of Cancer echoes those qualities of the moon. The sign rules the third eye chakra and is known for its intuitiveness, high intuition actually, nurturing capacity and emotionality. With that said, emotions can run high and deep, especially with Mars and Aries at the same time. So be prepared for others or even perhaps ourselves to be highly emotional and sensitive at this time. But intuition will be high, so trust it. So with the moon in Cancer, take care of yourself. The moon has a bright side and it has a dark side, our shadow. Triggers are formed by our shadows, so be kind and non-judgmental with yourself if you're going through deep emotions. It's best to acknowledge them. Sometimes just acknowledging it is enough to set you free, but sometimes it takes a little more than that. And if you find yourself needing some of that assistance with it, we can work together. I've been helping people gently dive into their subconscious to reveal the trapped emotions that might be ready to be released. This can ultimately be very life-changing. You don't need to be afraid or controlled by your shadow self, or what I call your programming. If you need my assistance, call me and we can talk. You can contact me via my new website, www.soulstar-alchemy.com. You can also read about all the other stuff I do and what I'm all about. So, from July 2nd through July 12th, all these planets will be in their home sign, and all these energies will be enhanced. The second powerful event is the Sirius Gateway Portal, which opens every year from July 3rd through July 7th. This is a time when we can tap into the higher frequencies of the brightest stars of Sirius. Unlike our sun, whose heat you can feel and its life-giving rays help grow the plants that nourish us, Sirius is 25.4 times greater and brighter than of our sun. But since it's 8.6 light years away, the ancient cultures, such as the Egyptians and the Sumerians, called it our internal sun, or our spiritual sun. They knew it was a place of higher consciousness. Recent discoveries revealed that we are actually downstream from Sirius, and it's transmitting its energy, which are highly charged particles, to our entire system via the magnetic field lines. Sirius is associated with liberation. In fact, according to ancient teachings, the very concept of freedom resides in human consciousness because of the influence of Sirius. Now that's a big claim, but check out these examples I found online. So during the Sirius Gateway Portal, some examples of liberation through history are America's Independence Day, which was yesterday, July 4th. Happy birthday, America! And speaking of birthdays, happy birthday to all of my July friends as well. Another example is that Canada claimed independence from England on July 1st, and Venezuela's Independence Day is observed on July 5th. Also, in 1993 through 1994, during the Great Conjunction of Sirius, which is a very auspicious placement of the planet Earth and Sirius and perhaps other planets, a wave of freedom swept all over the world, eventually resulting in the breakdown of communist rule in Europe and the liberation of the Russian people from the Communist Party. Also, the Berlin Wall fell as the Cold War ended. These events coincided and transpired simultaneously with the magnetic forces building to peak intensity on Sirius. Today, we are at the peak of the potent energies of the Sirius Gateway Portal, which opened on July 3rd and will remain open until July 7th. So we are smack dab in the peak intensity of this portal. The intention of this guided meditation crystal sound bath is for us to clear space, to say goodbye with gratitude to the things we need to liberate ourselves from. Remember, when one door closes, another will open. In the guided meditation I'll be doing today, I'll be playing the singing crystal bowls corresponding to each of the chakras involved. These crystal singing bowls are tuned to the frequency of 432 Hertz, which is also the frequency of love, and it's also the frequency of our universe. So, when you're ready, those headphones or earbuds on, kick back and relax, and soak in the healing vibrations with precise intentions of freedom, liberation, clearing your path, and manifesting positive changes that are ready to come to you. Ready? Okay, let's do this. Close your eyes and take three deep cleansing breaths with me. In, out. In and out. In and out. Now draw your attention to your tailbone. Feel the ground or the bed or chair that you are sitting or lying down on. If you are lying down, bend your knees and rock real gently from side to side. If you are sitting up, also rock gently, but back and forth. Feel your tailbone and sacrum as you rock. Start to feel the connection between you and the earth below you. Now imagine some roots starting to grow from the tip of your tailbone and extending down into Mother Earth. These roots are growing strong and sturdy, growing prolifically into the deep, rich, dark, nourishing soil of our dear Mother Earth, who is always willing to help us heal. You feel anchored, supported, nurtured, and safe. Now, draw your attention to your heart. The heart always tells the truth. It offers to us its sacred, loving knowledge. All we must do is connect and learn to listen. Imagine the deepest feeling of love you've ever felt. It could be a vision of a beautiful memory, a feeling, a thought. In your heart. See colors if you want to. Maybe pinks or reds or a serene green. Now feel that love energy expanding from inside your heart. The love energy grows bigger and bigger, infusing your entire body, surrounding you from your head to your feet and from your front to your back. With every breath and every heartbeat, your bubble of love grows larger and larger, extending out and starting to infuse the world around you. Feel that love extend outward and start to infuse your neighborhood, your city, growing bigger and stronger, infusing your state, now the entire country, the soil and the ground underneath you as well, and this beautiful love energy expands and surrounds our entire earth. Take a deep breath in. Exactly where to go and connects with the bluish-white light of the star Sirius. You are now connected. Allow this bluish-white light to come down the top of your head, showering you with a sparkling light from your head to your feet, while keeping your intentions strong in your mind. If you want, you can call in your spirit guide or an ascended master, like Saint Germain and the sacred violet flame of freedom, for self and world transformation. Now take a deep breath in and hold it. At the next exhale, let that energy fill your core, starting at the top of your head, exhaling now down your spine, both arms and legs, and out through the bottoms of your feet, nourishing the roots you've created that are anchoring you to Mother Earth. Run this energy for a few moments from the top of your head and through your roots, keeping your intention in mind. Sense this energy inside you and around you. As you send it down through your roots, let this powerful bluish-white light fill the earth, sharing the sparkling energy that you have connected with gratitude and love. When you're ready, face your palms towards each other, as if you're holding an invisible balloon. Imagine you can feel a vibrating energy between your hands. What you're doing is condensing the energy into a powerful ball of light. Now move your hands closer to each other. Do you feel anything between your hands? Do you feel a vibration or warmth or a tingling feeling? If not, don't worry. The energy is there. It just takes practice to sense it. Trust that you are holding this life-changing great ball of sparkling energy in your hands. Now condense it even more. Shape it into the size of a small watermelon. And just because it's a smaller size than it originally was, it doesn't mean that it's less powerful. Energy cannot disappear, it can only transform. So now, bring this ball of light to the level a little below your navel. Feel and see the sparkling ball of light between your hands. And when you're ready, place it into the space in between your navel and your sacrum. This area is between your root and sacral chakras, or energy centers. In Chinese medicine, it is the lower dantian, which is the seat of the life force energy and is believed to be like kundalini energy. This area can feel heat when activated to transform and awaken the upper energy centers in our body. You have now stored this transformational energy in this space. When you feel you have achieved your intentions, or you no longer feel the need to store it, you may simply intend to release it and send the energy down and out of your grounding roots. But for now, it is there to assist you in the clearing of your path to be able to achieve self-transformation and return to self-sovereignty. Now, when you are ready,
We'll take 3 slow, deep breaths. Coming back into your body. Moving your fingers and toes. Coming back now, starting to move around. Stretch if you feel the need, and yawn if you need. And now take a deep breath and gently open your eyes.
Welcome back, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this guided meditation. Feel free to do this meditation over again since the gateway doesn't close for a couple more days and the planetary alignment does not end until July 12th. I put the time of the start of the meditation in the description below. If you click on it, it will bring you to the right place in this video. If this meditation is useful for you, please let me know by hitting the thumbs up button below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and click the bell icon next to the subscribe button to be notified when I post a new video or do a live stream. If you would like a healing session or sessions from me, visit soulstar-alchemy.com and see the descriptions of my wonderful offerings. I've also updated my website, so check it out. I feel very blessed to be able to share my passion for healing with all of you during these super powerful days of the Sirius Gateway Portal together with the planets in each of their own astrological home signs. Coincidence? I believe not. This is synchronicity at its best. It is time for humankind to clear out the BS to get our power back and feel empowered so we can take care of ourselves and be better stewards of our Mother Earth. Remember, we're all in this together. Thank you again for joining me. I hope you had a safe and joyful Independence Day. Until next time, I'm Gemma at Soulstar Alchemy. Have a very blessed day and love one another. Bye.